वेलकम फ्रेंड्स, नाउ वी हैव अराइव्ड द लास्ट सेक्शन ऑफ द थर्ड यूनिट विच इज़ कॉल्ड डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ इनकम आउटपुट एंड एम्प्लॉयमेंट। इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव बीन डिस्कस्ड द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ डिफिशिएंट डिमांड। नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ एक्सेस डिमांड, जस्ट रिवर्स द सिचुएशन ऑफ डिफिशिएंट डिमांड। नाउ when equilibrium level of income or output is greater than the full employment level of income and output, it is due to the fact when aggregate demand becomes more than the aggregate supply at full employment. This situation is called the excess demand. So in short, we can say that when aggregate demand is more than the aggregate supply at full employment, it is a situation of excess demand. So here AD is greater than AS at full employment. This situation will lead to excess demand and it will create the inflationary pressures over the economy. Why inflationary pressures? Because these pressures or this gap as you see in the diagram, this gap between F and G is known as inflationary gap. Here I will write inflationary gap. Why it is called inflationary? Because it sets in motion the forces which cause inflation or price rise in the economy. Here it is clear from the diagram that we measure income and output on OX axis. We measure X and T aggregate demand, X and T aggregate supply on OY axis. Here the economy is operating over the full employment level because the full employment equilibrium at point F. But the initial aggregate demand curve is AD0. So at full employment level, which is at point F, the equilibrium output is OQ. This is equilibrium level of output, which is equal to OQ. And at this level of equilibrium, the aggregate demand will be FQ. The equilibrium level of output is FQ or OQ, and the aggregate demand is required equal to FQ because point F is lying on the 45 degree line, which is also known as the aggregate supply curve. But we see that aggregate demand is higher, it is operating here. So GF amount is more than the required FQ. So aggregate demand is GQ, while how much is required? FQ, for being on the full employment equilibrium of the economy. So this amount, which is equal to GF, is creating the inflationary gap and hence the inflationary pressure over the economy, which will lead to the rise in general price level. So as you see that this is point E. Economy is in equilibrium at this point, which is higher than the required point F. So how it will impact over the economy? Here we will see impact of excess demand on economy. First, its impact on the level of employment. Now, dear learners, please try to understand that as we know that economy is already working at the level of full employment, so there is no further scope for generating more employment. So there will be no change on employment. If we will talk about the output, on output, now we should understand that at point F where the economy is in full employment level of income and output. So this is that level of output OQ which an economy can produce at its maximum level, because it is the maximum capacity which the economy can produce by employing all the factors of production. Because the full employment level is that level where all the factors of production are, or where all the factors of employment are fully employed. So if the all factors of production are fully employed, then this is the level where the economy can produce maximum. So output will not be changed. There will be no change in the level of output. Now what will happen on general price level? On general price level. Now as we know that the real output cannot be increased, so the higher demand will create the inflationary pressures over the economy only. So there will be rise in the general price level. So general price level will increase. It will increase. Right? Now we see what will happen on the level of income. As we know that economy is operating at full employment, and full employment is the level where all the factors of production are fully employed. It is the point where economy is using its maximum capacity of production. So there will be no change in the real output. But this rising price level will increase the nominal income in the economy. So it will increase only nominal income. So there will be increase in there will be increase in nominal income only. In nominal income only. As we know that real income cannot be increased. That is why we know that real income or real GDP is a good measure or good indicator for measuring the economy. So that is why, because the real output or the real income is calculated at base price. That will be increased only when the output will increase. And in this situation, the output cannot be increased because economy is already operating at full employment level, which is the maximum level of output produced in an economy. So real output cannot be increased, but due to the price rise, due to the inflationary pressures, there will be increase in nominal income only. So now we will talk about the remedies. What are the remedies to correct the situation of excess demand, as it is yet again the unfavorable situation in the economy, as far as similarly as the deficient demand or excess demand, both are the unfavorable situation for the economy which has to be corrected. So you can pause the video to note it down, and then I will tell you the remedies to correct it. So in order to correct the inflationary gap, the aggregate demand has to be reduced up to the inflationary gap, this one, GF. And please remember that we are discussing the two-sector economic model, where there are only two sectors, the household and the production sector. So the aggregate demand can be decreased by decreasing the autonomous investment only. So that is why we have shifted this aggregate demand curve from A bar 0 to A bar 1, AD 1. And now economy will be operating at full employment level of equilibrium of income and output. So, but in reality, as we know that government has to take two measures. First one is fiscal measures, so fiscal policy measures, and second one is monetary policy measures. As far as the fiscal policy measures, as we have discussed in case of deficient demand, here government will do the reverse. Government will increase the taxation, hence people will have less purchasing power, and then the aggregate demand will goes down. Similarly, government will decrease its own expenditure and people will have less personal disposable income and the level of aggregate demand will be decreased up to this GF amount. And as far as the monetary policy measures are concerned, which is taken by the central bank of the country, here in India we called is what is called as RBI, Reserve Bank of India. So here in that case of deficient demand, it was in decreasing various rates and reserves to increase the money supply in the economy. But here the aim is to decrease the money supply, so it will increase all the rates. It will increase the bank rates, then borrowing money from the central bank by the commercial bank will be dearer, and hence they will have less money. Less money means less capacity for credit creation, and less credit creation means people will have less money. And similarly, increase in CRR and SLR, this we have explained in details while we were dealing the second unit of money and banking. So that is why I am moving pretty fast. So you can understand this. Just try to recall these reserves, cash reserve ratio, the amount which the all commercial banks has to kept compulsorily with the central bank, if it will increase, and SLR is statutory liquidity ratio. This is that fraction of amount which has to be kept by themselves only from the commercial bank sides. So if these reserves will be increased, then they have to keep more money in the form of reserves, and if they keep more money, then they will have less money for credit creation capacity. Hence the money supply will be decrease, and it will combat the situation of inflationary pressures. Similarly, there will be increase in bank rates, repo rate and reverse repo rate. If these rates will be increased, then the money from the central bank will be dearer. Hiring money, taking money from the central bank will be dearer. So they will take less money, and or if they take or if they borrow money from the central bank, then they will create the credit at higher rate of interest. So at higher rate of interest, less people will borrow. And increase in margin requirements, it is another aspects which will decrease the money supply in the economy. And then this is one of the main important point, selling of government securities in open market. This is called open market operation. In the case of deficient demand, this RBI was purchasing the government securities. Why it was purchasing? To increase the money supply there. But in this situation, as the target is to decrease the money supply, so it will sell the government securities in open market, like treasury bills, national savings certificate, etc. And by selling these securities, it will suck the liquidity from the economy, and hence people will have less money. Less money will lead to less purchasing power, and less purchasing power will be caused to the aggregate demand coming down. And in this way, the economy will be operating once again at the level of full employment equilibrium of income and output, which is the maximum level of output produced by an economy. So this is what the concepts of excess demand is all about. In previous video, we have discussed the deficient demand, and in this video, we have dealt with excess demand. So that's all for the unit number 3, which is determination of income, output and employment. From the next class, we will be beginning with yet another interesting topic, which is the government budget and the economy, which will be having the 6 marks weightage in your examinations. Thank you.